The Mask of the Red Death. There once was a kingdom that flourished with prosperity and good spirits until the Red Death plagued the people all across the kingdom. When diseased with the Red Death, one would feel sharp pain, become pale white, and bleed profusely from their pores. Innocent children were shunned from their homes, and those infected were ejected. But even in this time of despair, the prince kept in good spirits. In the midst of the tragedy, the prince threw a party, the masquerade.
You. That means that our country has been overcome with the Red Death, that we are having a cordial ball in my castle. This is a masquerade-style ball, and please don't bring in the Red Death. It'd be much appreciated. Thank you for your time, and we'll hope to see you soon.
There were many rooms in the castle. The blue room. The green room. The white room. And the infamous Red Room, which everyone was afraid of because of the large clock.
It is such an honor!
Good evening!
Okay, stand up.
Good evening!
Good evening.
She's a man, it'll make you hot, cause make you like here and she went to go to drink. She, no, we just haven't seen her.
She's gone. Like,
maybe she went to the powder room.
Maybe.
Who is that? Oh my gosh! Get with him!
Do I
have to?
Now it!
Fine, whatever. I guess I'll go to clean up your dirty work again. Hello? Taylor, why are you always laying around? Gotta do everything but...
And now is acknowledged the presence of the Red Death. He had come like a thief in the night, and one by one dropped the revelers in the blood-bedewed halls of their revel, and died each in the despairing posture of his fall. And the life of the ebony clock went out with the last of the gay, and the flames of the tripods expired, and darkness and decay and the Red Death held illimitable dominion over all.